kids, welcome to Sunday School Online. This is the second Sunday of the year and we are just getting started. And I am excited and I know kids, you are excited too. Like I promised you always, we are gonna have a lot of fun things coming ahead only for you in Sunday School with New City Kids. All right, so as usual, we're gonna do the same stuff, but as Sundays come in, we're gonna make it more exciting and we would need your help. For more information, we will keep you updated. So do keep a track of our social media sites so that you will know what are the new things that are gonna come in the coming Sundays. Are you ready for some fun time? I know you are. So what next? Did somebody say that we need to go ahead and praise the Lord? Absolutely correct, kids. So let's go ahead. It's singing and dancing time. Was it amazing time of singing and dancing? My favorite part during the whole episode is to sing and dance and sing praises to our Lord. I know a lot of you enjoy that. If you do, maybe try sending us some of your recordings of how you dance and praise the Lord. We would definitely love to see those and even show it to others by putting it on our social media. Wonderful kids. Now that we had some fun with dancing and singing, it's time for going ahead and learning, don't you think? So, why wait? Let's go ahead and call upon teacher Agnes to tell us today something new in story time.
Jacob had received his father Isaac's blessing by deceiving him and his brother Esau. Esau was angry at his brother and vowed to kill him. His mother Rebekah came to know of this and went to warn him.
Son, you must listen to me very carefully. Your brother is angry at you, and he has taken a vow to kill you. You must leave now and escape to Haran, where my brother Laban lives with his family. Stay there until your brother forgets what happened and find the heart to forgive you. Go now and stay there until I send for you.
Very well, mother, as you wish.
Now Rebecca wanted to send Jacob to her father's house with Isaac's blessing, but she had to present it differently. So she went up to Isaac and spoke to him.
Isaac, I have something to tell you. It's about Jacob.
I've been thinking about Jacob too. What is it, Rebecca?
I do not want Jacob to marry a girl from Canaan. I don't think that any girl from Canaan would suit Jacob. Why don't we send Jacob to my brother Laban for a while, so he can find somebody there?
That sounds like a good idea, Rebecca. Send Jacob to me, so I can talk to him about this.
Did you call for me, Father?
Yes, Jacob. You need to go to Laban, your uncle in Haran. It's a long journey from here, but it will be worth it. You can choose a woman from Haran to be your wife. You have my blessings. You will be a leader of the people, and you will have a nation to your name if you follow God's will. Go now and be blessed.
And so, Jacob left Beersheba for Haran. He traveled for several days through the desert and the wilderness. He had to face several hardships on the journey. One night, he reached an open space, and he couldn't see because it was too dark. So, he decided to rest the night there. He took a rock and rested his head on the rock. Soon, Jacob fell into a deep sleep. He had a dream, and what a strange dream it was.
I am the Lord, the one true God that your father Isaac and his father Abraham worshipped. The land that you sleep on will be yours. Your descendants will grow and flourish all over the earth. They will be as many as the sands on the seashore. Wherever you may go, you will be protected by me. You will have nothing to fear, for I am always with you. I will bring you back to this land, and I will never leave you until this promise has been fulfilled.
Jacob woke up from his sleep, and for a moment, he could not believe that he had dreamt all of this. He realized that this was indeed the land of God, and that God was telling him something. In the morning, Jacob woke up early and set the stone he had rested his head on as a pillar. He then anointed the stone with some oil and named the place as Bethel. At that moment, Jacob took a vow.
I go on this journey, and the Lord is with me, gives me food to eat, water to drink. and clothes to wear. And if I return safely back to my father's house, then I promise that the Lord will be my God forever. The stone that I have set up here will be the house of God. I also promise that whatever wealth that I may make, I will give a tenth of it to God. And so, the strange dream that Jacob had changed Jacob completely. And through this dream, he realized that God would be with him everywhere he went and protect him against all dangers.
Hey kids, such a beautiful story, right? Yes, you know what the learning is? God tells us his plan even through our dreams. One more time. God tells us his plan even through our dreams. And this week's memory verse is, "And above it stood the Lord, and he said, I am the Lord, the God of your father Abraham and the God of Isaac. I will give you and your descendants the land on which you are lying." Genesis chapter 28, verse 13. Let's say that verse again. Ready? Yes. "And above it stood the Lord, and he said, I am the Lord, the God of Abraham and the God of Isaac. I will give you and your descendants the land on which you're lying." Genesis chapter 28, verse 13. Meet you all next week, kids. Bye.
Thank you, Teacher Agnes. Thank you for that wonderful time of story. As usual, you make sure that the kids learn and learn well. It's craft time. That amazing craft lessons that you teach. It's fun to go in and do that, and I know that kids are getting creative, and I must admit, I also do try doing that craft so that I could impress my people. All right, so thank you once again. Kids, go ahead and impress your parents, or just go ahead and make some more creative stuff and show it up. Send us your pictures, and we would love to see what you made and how you made. And as usual, if it is good, we'll put it up on our social site. Wonderful, kids. So, now that we had a lot of fun and a lot of learning throughout the episode today, what do we do before we leave or before we end today's episode? Come on, kids, don't make those faces. It's just the second Sunday. We're gonna have a lot of fun, right? So, let's call it and end with a happy note. But what are we gonna do before we end? Did somebody say prayer? Absolutely correct, kids. We definitely are going to pray before we close today. So let's call upon Teacher Chandrika, because as she leads us today in prayer time.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day and this time of Sunday school. We thank you for teaching us. Bless our teachers who taught us and give us wisdom to live for you. Be with us till we meet the next time. Keep us safe. We thank you once again, and we offer this prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Teacher Chandrika. And everybody said amen definitely to that. Thank you once again for that time of prayer. And kids, I know you had a lot of fun, but until next week, what do we say? Bye!